वेलकम बैक एवरी वन. एज वी आर डूइंग अ गुडविल चैप्टर द वैल्यूएशन ऑफ गुडविल एंड वी हैड डन द थ्री मेथड दैट इज़ एवरेज प्रॉफिट मेथड, सुपर प्रॉफिट मेथड एंड कैपिटलाइजेशन मेथड. सो दिस इज़ द क्वेश्चन इन विच यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू ऑफ द गुडविल बाय ऑल द थ्री मेथड्स. सो देयर इज़ अ क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम द फॉलोइंग इन्फॉर्मेशन कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू ऑफ द मर्सेस शर्मा एंड गुप्ता. दैट मीन्स देर आर टू पार्टनर्स. क्लियर? एट द 3 ईयर्स परचेज ऑफ एवरेज प्रॉफिट, एट 3 ईयर्स परचेज ऑफ सुपर प्रॉफिट, ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ कैपिटलाइजेशन ऑफ सुपर प्रॉफिट एंड ऑन द बेस ऑफ कैपिटलाइजेशन ऑफ एवरेज प्रॉफिट. सो दिस मीन्स दैट यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू ऑफ द गुडविल ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दीज 4 मेथड्स. क्लियर? नाउ द इंफॉर्मेशन गिवन इज the average capital employed. Average capital employed. If the average capital employed is given, then it will only be used in the method of capitalization of goodwill under average profit method. Clear? Now next is net profit is given. Then for 2017, that is 1,60,000, 2018, 1,40,000, and 2019, 2,70,000. And these 3 years, the company is earning the profits. Clear? Next, the normal rate of return on capital is 11%. Remuneration means salary to each partner. And how many partners are there? 2 partners. So each partner's salary is 2,500 per month. Next is assets excluding goodwill. That means these are known as the net assets, 11 lakh, and the liabilities of 1 lakh rupees. Now we are going to calculate the answers of these four topics. That is, first is the calculation of the average profit, goodwill according to the average profit. For this, we have to calculate firstly the average profit. First step is to calculate the average profits. So average profits is equal to the profits of all the years, that is 2017, 18 and 19. The profits are 1,60,000 plus 1,40,000 plus 2,70,000, and you have to divide it with 3, and your average profits are divided by 3, that is rupees 1,90,000. Now in this question, the remuneration of each partner is given, so it is a future expense, so you have to deduct the value of remuneration from your average profits. So in this step, you have to calculate average normal profits, that is average profits minus remuneration. Average profits are 1,90,000 minus remuneration 2,500 per month each partner. That means 2,500 into 12 for the full year. If the value of the salary for per month is 2,500, then for the year it will be multiplied with the 12. And there are 2 partners, so it will be multiplied with 2. So the answer is 2,500 into 12 into 2 is rupees 60,000, and your normal profits are rupees 1,30,000, and then the goodwill is equal to average profits into normal number of years purchase. Average profits are 1,30,000. And according to the average profit method, the number of years purchased are 3. So the value of goodwill is rupees 3,90,000. Clear? Now, second is super profit method. For this, we have to calculate the capital employed firstly. But the value of capital employed is already given in the question, that is 10 lakh. So here it becomes 10 lakh. Second step is to calculate the average profits, but we already have the average profits, that is द वैल्यू ऑफ एवरेज प्रॉफिट इज 1,30,000, सो 1,30,000. थर्ड इज टू कैलकुलेट द नॉर्मल प्रॉफिट्स. वट इज़ द फॉर्मूला ऑफ नॉर्मल प्रॉफिट्स? दैट इज कैपिटल एम्प्लॉयड इन टू नॉर्मल रेट ओवर 100. सो कैपिटल एम्प्लॉयड इज 10 लैख एंड नॉर्मल रेट इज 11%. सो योर नॉर्मल प्रॉफिट्स आर रुपीज 1,10,000. फोर स्टेप इज टू कैलकुलेट सुपर प्रॉफिट्स. सुपर प्रॉफिट्स इज इक्वल टू एवरेज प्रॉफिट माइनस नॉर्मल प्रॉफिट. सो 1,30,000 माइनस 1,10,000, योर आंसर इज रुपीज 20,000. एंड द वैल्यू ऑफ गुडविल इज इक्वल टू सुपर प्रॉफिट्स इंटू नंबर ऑफ ईयर्स परचेज, दैट इज 3. दैट मीन्स 20,000 इंटू 3, द वैल्यू ऑफ गुडविल इज 60,000. In the first step, in the first method, sorry, there is 3,90,000, and according to the super profit method, the answer is 60,000. And now, if we do the capitalization method according to super profit, that is, capitalization of super profits. For this, we already had calculated the value of super profits. The super profits are, the value of super profit is rupees 20,000. So super profits are 20,000, and the formula for goodwill is goodwill is equal to super profits into 100 over normal rate. Super profits are 20,000 into 100 over normal rate is 11. So the answer is a round off amount, that is rupees 1,81,880. Clear? Now the last is capitalization of average profits. For this, you have to calculate the amount of the total capitalized value of the business. Now in this first is you have to calculate the average profits, and you have the value of the average profits, that is rupees 1,30,000. Second step is to calculate the total capitalized value of business. That is average profits into 100 over normal rate. That is average profit are 1,30,000 into 100 over 11. So your total capitalized value becomes rupees 1,81,880. Clear? Third step is to calculate the net assets. You are given here assets and liabilities. So net assets are total assets minus liabilities. That is assets amount is 11 lakh, and the liabilities amount is rupees 1 lakh. So your net assets are 10 lakh. Clear? And the last step is to calculate the value of the goodwill. So goodwill is equal to, formula of goodwill is capitalized value of business minus net assets. Capitalized value of business is 1,81,818 minus 10 lakh. Your answer is rupees 1,81,880. Now see, If you are calculating the value of the goodwill according to a capitalization method, rather it is a super method or a average profit method, the value of the goodwill will be same always. The value of goodwill will be same whether you choose this method, whether you choose this method, the value of the goodwill will always remain the same, but not in the case of the average profit method or the super profit method. In these cases, the answer will not be the same, but in the capitalization method, the values of the goodwill will be the same. Okay.